In the last video, we had just started to get into meiosis, and to be more precise, meiosis I, and to be even more precise in that prophase I, but we spent a good bit of time on prophase I because some interesting things happened. Some things happened just like prophase and mitosis, where the nuclear envelope disappears or starts to disappear. You have the chromosomes get into their dense form that has kind of this classic shape that you could see from a microscope. But what was unique or what was interesting about meiosis I and prophase I in particular is that you have this chromosomal crossover, that it's a pretty typical thing to happen in meiosis I. And it happens tends to happen in a fairly clean way, where homologous sections of these homologous pairs cross over. So they tend to these sections of the chromosome tend to code for the same genes. They're just different variants of those same genes. They might have different alleles. And once again, this just adds more variation as we get into sexual reproduction. So it's a kind of a neat thing that happens here. But now let's continue with meiosis, and in particular meiosis I, and you could guess what the next phase is going to be called. It is metaphase I. Metaphase I. And it has some similarities with metaphase and mitosis. So in metaphase I, so let me draw my cell. So this is the cellular membrane right over there. I have my centrosomes, which are now going to play more significant roles. The nuclear membrane is now gone. And just like in metaphase and mitosis, my chromosomes are going to line up along here I'll draw it kind of this up-down axis. So let's do that. So you have this one right over here. This is one chromosome. Two sister chromatids, and we had the chromosomal crossover, so it has a little bit of pink here. I'm gonna have to take a little bit of time to switch colors a little bit more frequently. And then you have the one, at least most of which you got from your mother. Yeah, but there's been a little bit of chromosomal crossover over here as well. So let me draw that. And then you have this one, and just for the sake of, so you have this one, this chromosome from your father. It has replicated, so it's now two sister chromatids, and this one from your mother. And I'm not going to show the chromosomal crossover here. Maybe it didn't happen over here. No homologous recombination over here. So these are, I guess, shorter. Now let me draw the centromeres. The centromeres I've started doing in this blue color. So the centromeres. The centromeres. And then the centrosomes, you have these microtubules that they can push the centrosomes away from each other, but they also attach at the kinetochores to the chromosomes, just like that. So, and these are, you know, the microtubules, you'll see people just talk about, oh, these connect and they're able to move things around. But this is, I find this incredible, that you just have a bunch of proteins through just kind of chemical and thermodynamic processes are able to do really interesting things like move chromosomes to different parts of the cell so that we eventually can get these gametes that can participate in sexual reproduction. This is an amazing thing, and you know, it's developed over billions of years of evolution, but it's just mind-boggling to think about the complexity. And not all of this is completely understood exactly how all of this works. I mean, you have these kind of motor proteins that help move the chromosomes along, these microtubules can elongate and shorten in interesting ways, so it's a really fascinating process. But anyway, this is what's happening in metaphase I. Now you can probably guess what happens after that. We then move to anaphase I. So we now go to anaphase I. I'll write that over here. Anaphase I. And just like in anaphase and mitosis, over here, the chromosomes start getting pulled apart. Except for one significant difference, and this is actually a very significant difference. In mitosis, the sister chromatids get pulled apart. The sister chromatids get pulled apart to become two daughter chromosomes. That does not happen in anaphase I. In anaphase I, the sister chromatids stay together. It's the homologous pairs that get pulled apart. So let me draw that. So this homologous pair up here gets pulled apart. The two sister chromatids do not get pulled apart here. So you have this one is getting pulled onto this side. So this one's getting pulled onto this side. It has a little bit from the original, so a little bit of that right over there. And then you have this one getting pulled on this side. So draw it the best I can. The colors, all right, so it looks like that. Although it's nice to have that, it's kind of easy to keep track of because these switch colors like that. And then you have this one getting pulled on this side. This one getting pulled on this side. And finally, this one getting pulled on to that side. And let me draw the centrosomes. So that's my, centrosome. And once again, it's pulling. Or I guess you could say the chromosomes being moved, and these things are pushing each other apart. The two centrosomes might be pushing apart to get to the opposite ends of the actual cell, but there's all sorts of interesting mechanisms that are bringing along these microtubules, bringing the chromosomes, once again, splitting the homologous pairs. And how they split is random. You know, this pink one could have been on the right side, this orange one could have been on the left side, or vice versa. And once again, this adds more kind of variation amongst the gametes. So even all of the resulting gametes that get produced, they all will have different genetic information. So this is anaphase one, you're pulling these apart. And then you can imagine what happens in telophase one. So telophase one, and this is fairly analogous to what happens in mitosis in telophase. So now you have your cytokinesis is beginning. So, and actually it might even begin earlier in mitosis. It happens as early as anaphase. At least the cytokinesis is starting, but you're starting to see that. These two things, the homologous pairs are fully split apart and they're at opposite ends. And actually they can begin to unravel into their chromatin state. So this one begin to unravel into its chromatin state. It has a little bit of the magenta. Whoops, it has a little bit of the magenta right over here. This is unraveling as well. This is unraveling like that, once again into its chromatin state. The cellular, the new, and let me do the other ones as well. So this is this one right over here, beginning to unravel. This one over here, beginning to unravel. It's got a little bit of orange on it. The nuclear membrane begins to form again. In some ways, it's reversing what happened in prophase I, where the nuclear membrane disappeared and the chromosomes condensed. And let me draw this is centrosomes, which are outside of the nuclear membrane, just like that. And the microtubules are also dissolving. And you have your cytokinesis. So these separate into two cells. So once again, when we did the overview of meiosis, we said, look, the first phase of meiosis, you go from a diploid germ cell to two haploid cells. And these aren't quite our end product yet. This right over here, what we have just gone through, all of this combined that we have just gone through, this is meiosis one. And in the next video, we're gonna go through meiosis two. Whoops. I didn't mean to do that. All of this is meiosis one. Let me write that in a different color, in bold. So this is all meiosis one here. And you can see each of these cells now have a haploid number. They now have the haploid number of two chromosomes each. Now each of those two chromosomes do have two sister chromatids. And as we'll see, meiosis two, which is very similar to mitosis, is going to split up the sister chromatids from each of these chromosomes, which gives us two daughter chromosomes. So we're gonna see that over here. So your haploid number here is two. You have two chromosomes here, and you have two chromosomes there. And we'll explore meiosis two in the next video.